TWiE, This Week in Education.
My name is Faris.
My name is Eric.
And we will begin this week's segment on Creativity 101, how to maximize the creativity in our students.
That's right, Faris. So we'll start as we always do with a quote by the king in education, Mr. Ken Robinson. He says, "Creativity is the process of having original ideas that have value.
It is a process, it is not random."
So with that said, we'll get to our first topic, proposed by Dr. Gordon Newfield. It is a meta-theory on attachment in the context of education. Let's get started.
Need to rest in a relationship. All growth emanates from a place of rest. Physical growth emanates from a place of rest. Psychological growth emanates from a rest. Well, what do we mean rest? Well, we now know that our work as humans is the work of closeness, of contact, of attachment. That's our work. And so the default setting is to make relationships work, to try to hold on to mommy and daddy, to try to preserve the connection to peers and so on. For that to be released, for a child to be released to move on to becoming their own person, for that to be there, somebody has to take responsibility. Children must never work for our love. They must rest in it. But unless the relationship is there, they cannot rest in it. We have gone to a practice of parenting and teaching that makes them work for the contact and closeness, that puts them in charge of the relationship. I can't be your friend if you're going to be like that. Off to your room, I withdraw the invitation to exist in my presence until you come into line. And we make them work at keeping us close. Well, we might get more compliance, but we get a deeply restless child. And we're giving rise to a whole generation of children who are restless to the core. They do not rest. Our yearning as parents and teachers, our yearning as grandparents, our yearning as uncles and aunts, where for our nephews and nieces, whatever it is, but as parents, our yearning should be to give them rest. Because when we can give them rest, when they can rest from working at keeping us close, when we take that alpha position and we say, I am the one who is going to make sure that nothing, honey, nothing can separate you from my love. You can rest in it. When we do this, when we don't withdraw our affection or our invitation to exist in our presence when there is a problem, when they are at rest, their developmental destiny will unfold. Their growth will become spontaneous and automatic. I always know when I see a child who is truly growing up, becoming mature, adaptive, emergent, and integrative being, I know that somewhere in their life, someone, an adult, someone the child is attached to deeply and vulnerably, has been able to give them rest, has been able to provide them what they need. Rest is absolutely essential. One of ways of giving a child rest is to make sure that we provide more than what is they need. You hear sometimes people say, well, don't pay any attention to him. You know, all he wants is attention. Well, what else is there to want? And if we see a child who wants attention, why wouldn't we give it to them? Why wouldn't we meet these basic needs of affection, of attention, of mattering, of significance? The fact is we must provide more. Those of you who have heard me speak or read in a book, I share this example of Tamara, my oldest. Now, I think she's 37. She's here. I won't ask her. She's 7 years of age. She was bright then. She still is. And we had this little interchange, this little I love you thing. She said to me, Daddy, I love you. Had that question mark in the back. It's meant to get an I love you too. It's like a little hook, you know, fish, and you send it back with a, you know. So I said, I love you too. And then there was this moment of pregnant silence. And she says to me, in childish wisdom, Daddy, if you really loved me, you would have said it first. The males here will recognize this as female logic. But it's true. It's true. Now, it didn't mean I had to say it first, but it meant that she was in charge. Do you see that? She was in charge. I needed to seize the lead. Oh, Tamara, I've got I had to have a bigger I love you. Or I had to, something I had to trump. It had to be trumped. You always have to give more for there to be relaxation. A person comes and asks you for a hug. Well, here's a hug. No, I need a hug. Here's a hug. Doesn't work. Why? How do you release a hug? You have to hug harder. That's always the way it is. The role of the parent is to give more than what is pursued. That is the only way a child can rest.
Wow, great talk by Dr. Gordon Newfield. I totally agree, Eric. Let's see how Chris Ulmer applies these concepts in the classroom.
You're very funny, you're very smart, you do a great job every day, and you make everyone laugh because you're so silly. Thanks for being a great student.
Awesome.
You're an amazing student.
Yes.
I love having you in my class.
Yes.
I think you're very funny.
Yes.
I think you're amazing.
Yes.
I think you are brilliant.
Yes.
I think everyone in here loves you.
Yes.
Great job. You are a great student.
Thank you.
I love having you in my class. You're funny.
Yeah.
You're athletic.
Yeah.
You're a great soccer player.
I know.
You're very smart.
Yes.
You've been doing a great job reading.
Yes.
You've been reading grade equivalent words, which means you're very smart.
Yeah.
Thanks for being a great student. I think you are a brilliant student. I love having you in my class. You're awesome. You're great. You're funny. You're silly. You're fast. You're strong. Thank you for being a great student.
Mr. Chris, you're the greatest teacher ever.
Thank you. You're a great student.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Wasn't it interesting how both individuals highlighted the concept of psychological safety, which we learned in Module 4?
Clarice, I couldn't say better myself. You know, I found it interesting and fascinating how these teachers were able to provide such safety that the kids are not able to express their creativity, which inherently has the risk of failing. And that's not an easy thing to instill in your students as a teacher.
I concur. Hey Eric, do you remember what Edwin Land said in Module 2?
Edwin Land said, an essential aspect of creativity is not being afraid to fail.
That's interesting. Let's take a look at how a teacher can play this role in the classroom.
Alright Eric, we're here for our architecture class once again. Yeah, I guess I picked up some material for you. Your task is, in 30 minutes, I need you to assemble the tallest structure you can make. Remember, no mistakes. We're striving for perfection here. I tolerate nothing but 100% from my students. I want your best effort, and at the same time, we're going to make a textbook on top. And for your sake, I hope you're able to make a structure that holds. Okay, you have 30 minutes. I'll see you then.
Yes, sir.
Good morning, buddy. How are you doing, Eric?
Good, Mr. Kassam. How are you?
Very good. So, today we've got a really exciting lesson planned. I've got some materials from here. We've got big popsicle sticks, little ones, and glue. What I want you to do is I want you to, in 30 minutes, you know, make the biggest structure you can. We're going to be supporting it on a textbook, and you know, I really hope you're able to make it successful. But remember, even if you make a mistake, it's a learning opportunity, and there's ways for us to improve in the future. So, good luck. I'm going to be sitting right here. If you have any questions, you come and ask me, okay?
Okay, thank you, Mr. Kassam.
Best of luck.
Mr. Kassam, I have
yes,
a question.
Absolutely.
If I put glue on both sides, should I put it on both sides or just one side and stick them together?
I think one side should do the trick, but again, it's what works for you.
Okay, thank
I'm
you.
I'm just going to stand right here and watch. Okay.
Yes. Mr. Kassam, it doesn't stand up.
That's okay. What we want to do then is we're going to take these two popsicle sticks, we can glue them together, and then we can form kind of a base structure like that, and like that. And then you can work your way up. Does that make sense?
Maybe.
Okay.
Can you try a different way?
Absolutely. Then we can also do a square as a base. And then you can build up
that.
Does that make sense?
Yeah. Okay, thank you so much.
Good?
Thank you.
looks really good. So now you have one of them, and why don't you make three and put it together, something like that.
Okay, I'll do that. Thank you, Mr. Dustin. Okay, it's been 30 minutes. Let's see what Eric created. All right, Eric. So it's been 30 minutes, and it's time to test the structure with this textbook right here. Let's give it a shot. Oh my God, are you kidding me? Eric, it's been 30 minutes. This is what you created?
Yes, sir.
You know, I need another 15-minute break. Think about your actions, see how you can improve, and I'll be back in a bit.
Okay.
All right, it's been 30 minutes. I can't wait to see what Eric's made for me.
Oh, hi, Mr. Gossin. I just finished.
Hey, Eric, let's take a look at what you did.
Well, I made the 1, 2, and 3 structures.
Wow, great
just
job,
like
buddy.
Said, I think they're okay.
They look great. So why don't we combine the 3 structures together and see if it will support the textbook?
All right. So we've got to stand them up first. And then...
Let's see. Do you have anything that could kind of hold the 3 structures together?
Oh, I know. I could use the hair tie my mom always tells me to use.
That would be a great idea.
And hold this together.
Wow, look at that. It holds together quite nicely.
Oh my goodness.
Great job, wow.
Hey, yeah, it works, look. Woo-hoo. Look, Mr. Kassab.
That looks awesome.
I think it's ready.
Okay, here we go, the moment of truth.
Okay.
Take a deep breath, buddy. Here we go.
I'm ready.
Whoa, look at that.
Hey, it works.
It's like magic. Wow.
It can even hold strong winds, Mr. Kassab.
Look at that, give me a big high five.
Woo. Yeah.
You should be so proud of yourself.
I am, thank you.
You know what, you earned a break. Let's go take a 10-minute break right now.
Wow, I believe it was Dr. Zhao who said, creativity can't be taught, but it can be killed.
I believe, Eric, if there was any video clip that would highlight this quote we just witnessed.
Hey, Faris, on a physiological note, rather than psychological, as we've been talking about up until now, on a physiological note, Module 3 talks about how the frontal lobe of the brain, as well as the right hemisphere, are involved in the creative process. Specifically, in moments of insight, as well as creativity in general.
That's interesting you say that. You know, I was looking at the newspaper the other day, and I read that to stimulate the frontal cortex, you know, dancing is an effective method to do that. In addition, singing is known to stimulate the right hemisphere.
Singing and dancing, you say? Well, it's funny you mentioned that. We actually have 2 video clips of students performing these activities to help promote creativity in the classroom. Let's take a look.
Yes, I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a yummy, tummy, funny, lucky gummy bear. I'm a jelly bear, 'cause I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a moving, grooving, jamming, singing gummy bear. Oh, yeah. Gummy, 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 gummy bear. Gummy, 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 gummy bear. Biting by Dolly Party, biting by Dolly Party, biting by Dolly Party, party pop. Pointing by Dolly Party, pointing by Dolly Party, pointing by Dolly Party, party pop. Oh, I'm a gummy bear, yes, I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a yummy, tummy, funny, lucky gummy bear. I'm a jelly bear, 'cause I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a moving, grooving, jamming, singing gummy bear. Oh, yeah.
Navidad, prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, feliz Navidad, feliz Navidad, prospero año y felicidad.
I want to wish you a Merry Christmas, with lots of presents to make you happy. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart.
That was some great stuff, Eric. You know, watching these clips kind of makes me want to move around a little bit.
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean, Faris. I feel kind of in the mood to move my body too. You know, it reminds me though, don't you do yoga?
No, why?
Oh, you know, I mean, it's just, like we found a picture of you actually the other day.
Picture? What is the picture you're referring to?
Let's show the audience, it's right there.
Well, okay, maybe I do yoga once in a while. You know, I think do it, don't do it. I think we're splitting hairs here.
Yeah, well, you know, it's all good. Each to their own. Nonetheless, I bring it up because aerobic exercise, such as yoga, brings you to a positive affect or in a good mood.
And didn't we learn in Module 3 that being in a positive mood allows you to be more creative?
In fact, we did, Faris. Yes, we did.
And you know what? I think I remember seeing a yoga class going on down the hall.
Over there,
yeah.
Of course you know this.
Well, you know what? I think we should head over and I can take you to school on yoga.
Take me to school, let's take the class to school.
Let's go. There we go.
Alright, so let's start by getting grounded in mountain pose. Spread out the toes. Shrug the shoulders up to the ears, back and down. One more time, inhaling up. And exhaling back and down. Maybe close the eyes. Breathe. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. One last time. Inhale. And exhale. All right, so we're going to do some partner stretching today. So if you can sit facing your partner, cross-legged, knee to knee. All right, and so each person is going to take their left hand behind the back. Mm-hmm. And then you're going to reach with the right hand to this hand. Yeah. All right, then inhale to lengthen the spine, grow up tall, and then exhale, twist to the side. This is called the infinity twist. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale to twist. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale to twist. We'll take the right hand now behind the back. Go to the opposite side. See if you can draw the... Yes, okay. Inhale to lengthen. And exhale, twist. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Nice. Okay, so you can let go of the hands now. Now we're going to sit still facing each other, but you'll bring your feet to touch so that you can take your feet to each other. Straight legs.
Oh, straight legs.
There we go. All right, so you might need to bend your knees a little bit so that you can grab hold of each other's hands.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't we
and then you're
down?
Going to seesaw back and forth.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Breathing. Nice. right, one more time in each direction. Right, and then you can release the hands. You're going to scoot bum a little bit closer so that the knees are bent, and you're going to take the toes to touch.
Okay.
And this time, grab hold of each other's wrists. Have a more secure grip.
There we go.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
All right, so then press into one leg to extend. Up, 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 up. Yeah!
That's
and then
really cool.
The other leg. Okay.
That's awesome.
Super, super good. Yeah. Now see if you can take one leg at a time outside of the arms.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
Oh yeah?
And then the opposite leg.
Oh my god. Feeling good, flexible, relaxed, and creative juices are flowing. I told you yoga was going to be a great idea, Eric. I'll never doubt you again, Emil. But there's one thing that's quite funny to me. You know, we've done yoga, we're in this creative headspace, but at the same time, we haven't quite applied ourselves yet.
I couldn't agree more, Faris. I do remember, however, in Module 6, we learned actually a technique that we can use in the classroom for students. It's called PBL, Problem-Based Learning.
It's funny you bring up PBL, because we actually have some clips of an amazing, amazing group of students that were able to transform milk into bone.
You say milk into bone outside the body?
You don't believe me, do you?
Nah.
Take a look at this clip right here.
Hi, Mr. Gasson.
Oh, hi, Eric. How are you doing?
Great. I'm really excited to do this project.
Wow, look at this. What do you have for us?
Well, since this is an anatomy class, I decided because bones have calcium, and so does milk, I'm going to turn milk into bones.
Milk into bone?
Yeah.
That sounds like magic.
It almost is, but there actually is a science to it, and I'm excited to explain it to you after I do it.
Okay, wonderful.
Now, can you explain to me how this ties into anatomy?
Well, because bones are a part of the anatomical structure, from as you can see on the slide there, it's part of what creates the framework and the structure of your body, where then the muscles attach to help you move, and then the circulatory system then pumps all the nutrients around your body to let it work, and nervous system so you can feel, touch, see, taste, hear. It's all part of it built together, but the foundations is bones, and the calcium is the foundation to that. So I want to...
Okay, wonderful. I can't wait to see your work. Go ahead.
Thank you.
Alright, it's time to check what Eric created. Hey Eric, wow, looks like you're all cleaned up and ready to go.
Yeah, I'm excited. So this is it. This is
the femur
of a cat, which is very, very tiny, but this is the bone structure. And so it's drying now. It takes about 48 hours to dry, but when it's done, it'll be as hard as a rock.
May I touch it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Whoa, it does feel very hard already. I can't wait to see what it's going to turn out in 2 days.
Oh, yeah.
Really good job.
Thank you, Mr.
Another Foster. High five.
Woo!
Congratulations.
Wow, those are some unreal special effects, Faris.
So let me get this straight here. You still don't believe that those amazing kids were able to transform milk into bone?
I guess so. All right.
Yes, they did. I'll give it to the sad forest. Yeah, the kids did it, and it was, honestly, it was amazing.
So as we close this segment, we'd like to share a quote from George Bernard Shaw.
George Bernard Shaw was a Nobel Prize winner for his creative genius and contributions in the domain of literature.
He says, "You see things, and you say why.
But I dream of things that never were, and say, why not?"
So from all of us here at TWiE, This Week in Education, we'd like to thank you for joining us this morning.
We'll see you next week.
Take one, here we go.
An essential aspect of creativity is to not be afraid.
Is not being afraid to fail.
Not.
Hey Eric, do you remember what Eric... No, sorry.